Hey scientists, and today we're going to explore the physical characteristics of plants and what can help them survive in different environments. Now, before we get into that, and before you guys get to check on your experiments from yesterday, first we got to do a little review activity, especially on some of our vocabulary. Before we talk about our activities for today, let's look at our essential questions that we're going to try to answer throughout our lesson today. Now, let's talk about our essential question. Remember, essential questions in science and in different lessons can help us think about what we already know about a topic, and it helps us connect to new ideas that we're going to learn today to help us produce a new thought about the topic. Our essential questions will be focused on our different science topics. So look for keywords. In those keywords, the minute you see them and recognize them, I want you to think, what do I already know about this topic? Once you have that in your mind, you want to look at the question again to see what we're trying to answer today or what are we trying to answer about that topic. It's important to remember that an essential question is like a goal as well. By the end of our science lesson, you should confidently be able to answer the essential question. Let's go over our essential question for today. Our essential questions for today are as followed. Listen as I read the first one. What basic needs must be met for plants to survive? Read that one with me. What basic needs must be met for plants to survive? Nicely done. Make sure you're saying these loud enough so I can hear you through the screen. Listen to number two. How do the different parts of a plant help it meet its basic needs? That one's a little bit longer, so read the screen as you say it with me. Ready? Here we go. How do the different parts of a plant help it meet its basic needs? Nice done, scientists. And the last one. Listen to me first. What comparisons can we make about the physical characteristics of plants that help them survive in different environments? Say that one with me. What comparisons can we make about the physical characteristics of plants that help them survive in different environments? We're going to try to answer these three essential questions today as we check back in with our lab. It's important that we know certain vocabulary, so as we make our observations and final conclusions, we're able to vocalize how we drew those conclusions, and we're able to tie it back to the material to understand why these plants have these different parts to survive in their specific areas. For our review activity for science today, you guys are going to need to grab your whiteboards and markers. We are going to be talking about different vocabulary words. You have learned the different motions to some of these vocabulary words and how to represent them with your body. As we go through the vocabulary words, I will read the definition and show you guys a picture on the screen. When you see the picture on the screen, you want to write on your whiteboards what word we are looking for and also stand and do the pose to remember the word. Let's go over the movements really quick first. The movements for this activity are on the screen now. Pause it and read it. Pause and review how to do each motion, saying the vocabulary word and then practicing the motion that goes along with it. Come back when you're ready to play. Goes along with it. Pause before I show the answer so you guys have time to write it down and strike your pose. A feature or trait that can be seen. A feature or trait that can be seen. Pause now. This is a physical characteristic. If you got physical characteristic, give yourself a high five. Next one. Pay attention to the arrow in this picture. A part of a plant that grows into the ground, absorbs water, and holds the plant in place. What vocabulary word matches? Pause now if you need more time. That's the roots. It's pointing to the roots underground. Let's go to our next one. Pay attention to where the arrow's pointing. A part of a plant that connects the roots and leaves and holds the plant up. Pause if you need more time. This is the stem of the plant. Let's look at another one. A thing made by many plants to produce seeds. This is a flower. The next one, pay attention to the arrow again. The definition is plant parts that are attached to the stem and make food for the plant. Pause now for more time. This part of the plant is the leaves of the plant. It's important not only to remember what the plant is called, but also its definition. Let's look at the next one. What a living thing must have to stay alive? What are these things called? Look at the different pictures. Pause for more time. The different things we need to stay alive, those are called our needs. We talked a lot about food, water, and shelter as some of our needs. The next definition says, the part of soil that helps plants survive and grow. The part of food that helps animals survive and grow. Pause for more time. This is called the nutrients. So nutrients. It's important we get our nutrients. They help us survive. For today's science activity, you guys are going to be exploring your different carnations that you left overnight yesterday in the dyed water. You made some hypotheses or predictions on what you thought was going to happen. Today, while you're making your observations, I want you to think about some of these questions. What some of these we even talked about today in class. What are the parts of plants and why are the functions of each and what are the functions of each part of plants? So we talked a lot about those when we viewed our vocabulary words today. It's important that when you're making your observations, don't just say statements, but talk specifically. If you're describing something, describe what part of the plant you're talking about. Are you talking about the stem, the leaves, the roots, the flowers? Let us know what you're exactly thinking. The second question that I want you guys to think about is what happens to flowers after they sat in the colored water overnight? So think about this experiment. I want you to talk about this as a class. Before you even look at your carnations for today, I want you to think about what will happen if you leave the water overnight. What do you think would happen if you were able to leave the water for 3 nights? And finally, what do you think would happen if you split the stem of the carnation so that the half of the stem was in one color of the water and the other half was in another color of the water? This question you'll have to look at back at when you finish looking at your carnations for today. Remember, carnations is another word for flowers. The specific flowers you guys have today are called carnation flowers. The first question is something that we talked about as a class today. It's important to remember those answers as you do your observations. Before you begin your observations, talk about that second question and revisit your hypothesis from yesterday. And the third question, after you've looked at your carnations, come back and I want you to write on your paper specifically. Make another hypothesis. What do you think would happen if you split your flower into two and put it in two different colors? The concept attainment quiz. So for this activity, you'll do some vocabulary matching. Remember, vocabulary was stressed in the activity we did and in the finishing up of your experiment that you're about to do. You're also going to be talking about identifying the different parts of the plant and each job they do. It's important to review these concepts during your experimenting today so that when it individually comes time to show your stuff, you're able to recall that information and relate it back to the experiment you completed. Good luck, scientists, and I'll see you guys soon.